The 3-week lockdown has been extended, and as some of us attempt to adapt to the new normal, many are still daydreaming of the day when this will all be over. And one aspect of society which has changed beyond recognition is of course the world of sport and the venues which host it. The Principality Stadium is more often than not depicted with 75,000 fans cheering their hopeful Grand Slam heroes. But now this iconic pitch is temporarily home to the heroes of the NHS in the form of the Dragon's Heart Hospital. It is the second largest such facility which has been created in the UK to help tackle coronavirus, behind of course the Nightingale Hospital in London. Around 300 beds have been made available, with CT scanners and X-ray machines also to be fitted. By the time of completion, there will be around 2,000 beds available for any patients who need them. A mere stone's throw away and in the shadow of the National Stadium, the Cardiff Arms Park is also being utilised as part of the Dragon's Heart Hospital. The home of Cardiff Blues will house a staff welfare centre, catering facilities and the headquarters for the hospital's facilities management. But it's not just the world of rugby which has grinded to a halt. However, EFL have made a major TV broadcast announcement as Cardiff City and Swansea City matches are now to be played behind closed doors. However, the Cardiff City Stadium on Leckwith Road has been pulled into a debate as to whether it was the right decision for the testing centre there to be closed last bank holiday Monday. The news came as the Welsh Government had only tested 14% of their mid-April target of 5,000 people a day. And in cricket, Glamorgan legend Robert Croft has joined a host of high-profile former cricketers in a Swansea Bay NHS video campaign to help stop the spread of COVID-19. Croft has called on the community to protect our country and stop the spread of the virus as part of the Let's Hit COVID-19 for Six campaign. Therefore, despite the world of sport currently sitting on the bench, the venues and people which make the Cardiff sports scene so special are certainly playing their part.